Hi, welcome back to machine learning tutorial. In this video I will discuss how to calculate the probabilities using Bayesian belief network. This is the solved example number 3 and this is the network given to us. In this case we have been given 4 nodes. The first one is battery, second one is fuel, third one is gauze and fourth one is start here. Now in this case the battery and fuel does not depend on anything, but the probability of gauze depends on battery as well as fuel. Similarly, the probability of start depends on battery and fuel. In this case we have been given the probabilities also, that is the probability of battery is equivalent to bad is 0.1. So in that case we have another possibility, that is the probability of battery is equivalent to good, that is 1 minus 0.1, that is 0.9 in that case. Similarly, probability of fuel is equivalent to empty is 0.2, hence the probability of fuel is non-empty is equivalent to 1 minus 0.2, that is 0.8 here. As I said earlier, the probability of gauze depends on battery and fuel. Hence, we have 4 possibilities here, that is battery is good, fuel is empty, battery is good, fuel is non-empty, battery is bad, fuel is empty, battery is bad, fuel is non-empty. So these are the 4 possibilities we will get. For gauze is equivalent to empty, and for gauze is equivalent to non-empty, again the 4 condition will come here. So one is shown, the remaining can be calculated with 1 minus this probabilities. So first one is the probability of G is equivalent to empty given battery is equivalent to good and fuel is non-empty, which is equivalent to 0.1. Probability of G is equivalent to empty given B is equivalent to good, fuel is equivalent to empty now, which is equivalent to 0.8. Probability of G is equivalent to empty given battery is bad, fuel is non-empty is equivalent to 0.2, and the last one is probability of G is equivalent to empty given battery is bad but fuel is empty, which is equivalent to 0.9 in this case. Now the other side, that is the probability of G is equivalent to non-empty, if you want to calculate it, 1 minus 0.9 we need to calculate, it will become 0.9 here, and this one will become probability of G is equivalent to non-empty in the second case, 1 minus 0.8, which is equivalent to 0.2, this will be 0.8 and this will be 0.1 in that case. Similarly, the probability of start depends on battery and fuel here. So the probability of start is equivalent to yes given these conditions, that is B is equivalent to good, F is equivalent to non-empty, 0.1. Probability of S is equivalent to no given B is equivalent to good, F is equivalent to empty, that's the second condition, 0.8. Probability of S is equivalent to no given B is equivalent to bad but F is equivalent to non-empty, that is 0.9. Probability of S is equivalent to no and given B is equivalent to bad and F is equivalent to empty is 1 here. Now the other side is what? Probability of S is equivalent to yes. We need to calculate 1 minus 0.1. Second one, 1 minus 0.8. Third one is 1 minus 0.9. And the fourth one is 1 minus 1.0. That is equivalent to 0. So those are the values we will get here. So once you understand these particular condition, that is how can we calculate the conditional probabilities for this particular Bayesian belief network, we can easily calculate the probabilities for these 3 questions here. So the first one is probability of B is equivalent to good, F is equivalent to empty, G is equivalent to empty, S is equivalent to yes here. So this is the probability of this condition I want to check. So now if you look at this particular thing or the network as such, the probability of battery and fuel does not depend on anything, as I said earlier. But the probability of gauze and start depends on fuel and battery here. Hence this equation can be written like, probability of B is equivalent to good remains as it is. Probability of F is equivalent to empty, it will become probability of F equals to empty. But this one, probability of G is equivalent to empty given the 2 conditions. The conditions are battery and fuel in this case. So battery, what is given to us? Good is given. So B is equivalent to good. Fuel, what is given? That's empty. F is equivalent to empty in this case. So this is the very important thing we need to understand here. Similarly, yes depends on what? Yes depends on again the battery and fuel here. Hence, the probability of yes is equal to yes given battery. What is the condition given? Good here. Fuel. What is the condition given? Empty. So that is what I have written here. Now, once you know this equation, only thing is we need to put the values and then come up with the final answer. So what is the probability of B is equal to good? B is equal to bad is 0.1. So B is equal to good is what? 0.9. So that is what I have written here. Similarly, probability of F is equal to empty, that is 0.2. It's already given here. So write that particular thing here. G is equal to empty given B is equal to good, F is equal to empty. So first we need to check G is equal to empty, F is equal to good, and B is equal to good and F is equal to empty. B is equal to good and F is equal to empty is 0.8 here. So that is the value we need to write over here. Now the last one is probability of S is equal to yes given B is equal to good, F is equal to empty. So B is equal to good, F is equal to empty is the second condition, but we are not expecting where is that? This one. B is equal to good, F is equal to empty. We are expecting S is equal to yes here, not S is equal to no. So the opposite of this one, that is 1 minus 0.8, which will become 0.2 in this case. So that is what is written in this case here, that is 0.2. Now if you multiply all these particular things, you will get 0.0288 in this case. So this is the probability of the first question here. Similarly, we will take one more question here, that is the probability of B is equal to bad, F is equal to empty, G is equal to non-empty, and S is equal to no here. Now, if you expand this equation, probability of battery does not depends on any other entity, so it will be outside here. Fuel does not depends on anything, so probability of F is equal to empty, but G depends on battery as well as fuel here, hence the probability of G is equal to non-empty given battery is equal to bad and F is equal to empty, that is fuel is equal to empty here, and probability of S is equal to no given B is equal to bad and F is equal to empty, because already given those, we have been given those condition here. Now we need to write the probabilities here, that is probability of B is equal to bad, that is 0.1. Second one is probability of F is equal to empty, that is 0.2. So we have written 0.1 and 0.2 here. Probability of G is equal to non-empty given B is equal to bad and F is equal to empty. B is equal to bad and F is equal to empty is the last condition here. But we are expecting G is equal to non-empty. The meaning is the opposite of this one, or you can say that 1 minus 0.9. That will become 0.1. So it is written over here. And the last condition is probability of S is equal to no given B is equal to bad and F is equal to empty here. Again, that is the last condition here. We are expecting S is equal to no only. So S is equal to no, this condition, that is 1.0. So that is written here. And if you multiply everything, you will get the probability as 0.002 here. This is the probability of the second question in this case. Now the third question is, in this case, it's something called as a marginal probability or something. Given the battery condition, that is the battery is bad, we need to compute the probability that the car will start. So that is what actually we need to do. The meaning of this one is, we know that the battery is bad. We want to know what is the probability that the car will start. So this is what actually the question here. Now how can you represent this one is, it can be represented something like this, that is the probability of S is equal to S given the battery is bad. We know that the battery is bad, what is the probability that the car will start? So that is what the meaning here. Now this is a conditional probability, if you expand it, it will become something like this, probability of S is equal to S, B is equal to bad divided by this term, that is B is equal to bad here. So this is a conditional probability equation here. Now, look at this particular numerator in this case. What is given to us is, we have been given the condition of S, and S is nothing but the last one, and this one, start and battery is given. These are the two things given to us. But what about others, gauze and fuel? We have not been given those two conditions. Now what we need to do is, we need to cross check, if I want to calculate this probability, do I need to know the value of gauze as well as fuel? So that is the first thing we need to check. If you want to calculate the probability of battery is equivalent to bad, we don't need to know anything because this is the uppermost entity in this case. But if you want to calculate the probability of yes or start here, that is the probability of start, we need to know what is the status of fuel as well as we need to know what is the status of battery here. We don't need to know what is the gauze, but we need to know what is the value of fuel and what is the value of battery. But battery is given to us already. What is given? It is given as bad. It's already given in the question. But we don't know what is the value of this particular fuel. So we need to consider one time it is empty and another time it is, can say that non-empty. And it is not required to consider in this case. So that is the reason the equation is written something like this. Probability of P, probability of S is equivalent to S, B is equivalent to bad, F is equivalent to alpha for all possible values. What are the possible values? One is empty, another one is non-empty. Those are the only two possibilities. So that is what the very important thing you need to know. That's the reason we have taken the summation term here. And divided by remains as it is, because we don't need anything to calculate the probability of battery is equivalent to bad in this case. Now, we try to expand this particular terms. How to calculate probability of S here? If you want to calculate the probability of S, probability of S is equivalent to S given battery is equivalent to bad and fuel is equivalent to alpha, because we don't know what is the status of alpha here. Alpha may be empty or it may be non-empty. And this one, probability of bad, it is as it is. And this one, probability of bad and F is equivalent to alpha. In the next step, it was expanded. This is kept as it is. This probability of B is equivalent to bad is written here. And if you want to calculate the probability of F, we don't need to know anything other than this thing. So that is written over here. Now, if you look at this one, this term and this term will get cancelled. So what is remaining is probability of S is equivalent to S given battery is equivalent to bad, fuel is equivalent to alpha, and probability of fuel is equivalent to alpha here. Now we need to expand this particular term by putting the possible values of alpha. First time we need to put empty, second time we need to put non-empty. That is probability of S is equivalent to S given battery is equivalent to bad and F is equivalent to empty here. That is what I have written. And probability of F is equivalent to empty, because we have considered empty, so we have to put it empty here. Second time non-empty, that is probability of S is equivalent to S given battery is equivalent to bad, F is equivalent to non-empty, multiplied by probability of F is equivalent to non-empty. This is a summation term over here, that's the reason plus is written. Now we need to put the probability values here and then we will get the final answer. So first we will try to put the first one. Probability of S is equivalent to S given B is equivalent to bad and F is equivalent to empty. Where is that B is equivalent to bad and F is equivalent to empty? This is the case. And we are expecting what here? We are expecting S should be yes here. But what is present here? S is equivalent to no is present. So S is equivalent to S is the opposite of this one. That is 1 minus 1.0. That will become 0 here. So that is what the first term. And then multiplied by probability of F is equivalent to empty. F is equivalent to empty is 0.2. So 0.2 is written over here. Coming back to the second term. Probability of S is equivalent to S again. But B is equivalent to bad and F is equivalent to non-empty in this case. B is equivalent to bad and F is equivalent to non-empty. But opposite of this one is required, because I am not expecting S is equivalent to no. I am expecting S is equivalent to S here. That is nothing but 1 minus 0.9. That is equivalent to 0.1 here. So that is what I have written here. And the last term is probability of F is equivalent to non-empty. Probability of empty is equivalent to 0.2. Probability of F is equivalent to non-empty is 1 minus 0.2. That is 0.8 here. So that is what I have written here. And this term will become 0, because 0 into 0.2 is 0. Plus 0.1 into 0.8 is equivalent to 0.08 here. So this is how you can calculate the probability of the car will start given the battery condition is bad in this case. So this is also called as the marginal probability in this case. So in this video I have discussed how can we calculate the condition, the probability of a given problem, as well as how can we calculate the marginal probability, that is the probability of a particular entity given the status of other entities. So in this case, we have been given the battery is bad. We want to calculate the probability that the car will start in this case. I hope the concept is clear. If you have any other questions, you can put those questions in the comment box below. I will try to answer those questions as early as possible. If you like the video, do like and share this video with all your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.